What is going on, guys? It's Wav here, and welcome back to some more Ark Survival Evolved here in Scorched Earth. Now, last time we left off, I said I was going to look for a high-level Ankylo, and I spotted one over here. That's level 163. I forget what the level that we're looking for is. It's like, okay, I think that's the one I was looking at before I started recording. Level 195 female right there. 37 baseline melee damage. 31 baseline carry weight. That's pretty good. Health, it doesn't really matter. Stamina doesn't really matter too much either. So, anyways, let's stay in this area. I don't know where I am right now. There's the green tower. There's the... Okay, I'm between the green tower and red tower over here. So if you guys are wondering, you know, where I'm finding these higher level Ankylos. Oh, might need to land here. I'm trying to see maybe if there's any higher level ones around here. What level is that one? Is that the one that we're trying to get? That black one? Yeah, that kind of black and brown one right there. I guess we're gonna... let's pick that one up. Let's pick that one up, and I guess we can just throw... Oh, it's kind of like a... It's got like a greenish-yellowish body. Look at that! Interesting stuff. Anyways, let's keep flying around this area. See if we can find a higher level Ankylo. Maybe one that has better melee damage stats and all that. What in the world is that? Something just got flung up in the air. What in the world? Oh! Is that a prime? That's a prime alpha. Yep, prime alpha Utah Raptor right there. Ooh. I was wondering because I was hearing that music playing. Okay, well, I'm not seeing any Ankylos right now other than the ones that I was just next to. And of course, what I think with that white, black and white one, I think that was like an Earth BA or something like that. And of course, those get rocks and stuff a lot more. What is that one? Is that the 167? Yeah, it's 163. I think the one that we have right now. I think it's a female, so it's not like we could breed a tank the Ankylo with this one. We're actually a lot closer to my base than I thought we were. Sheesh. Yeah, I'm not seeing like any more Ankylos around here. Huh. And of course it seems like BA ones always seem to be a lower level than regular ones, so if you guys are like, hey, why don't you go tame that BA Earth BA one? Well, I think it's like a level 10 or something like that, so it's not really that high level, even if it does have a little bit of a bonus for getting a like stone and whatnot. But this seems like it's a pretty good tame, and I assume, just like a lot of things I've been taming recently, I assume it's gonna get a pretty good taming bonus, and that's gonna boost up its baseline stats, baseline multipliers as well. So that's definitely something to look forward to. Anyways, we do have this, like, T-Rex is on one side, Argy's on one side. I guess we could put the T-Rexes, let's put the Ankylo, like, right here. We are going to try and passively tame it. It's going to be a lot easier to try and passively tame it in a, closed-off area like this, but, there you go. Get the Sav Roots. Can I put the Sav Roots there? There you go. Let me see if I can passively tame this thing. Put taming food and lodge. I don't know why it doesn't like vegetables. Pretty sure it eats vegetables, and of course it eats kibble too, but that's why I brought these Miho berries over here. There we go, Miho berry right there. Not bad. 97. Man, this thing's going to be almost level 300 if I get 100% taming bonus. This thing seems like it's pretty hungry. Not bad. It's eating pretty often right now. 97 plus 195, that's going to be just under level 300. What is that, 292 or something like that? That's insane! And of course, it's probably going to go down. Taming bonus, I guess you could say, jeez. It's probably going to be like 94, 95 or something, if we're lucky, because we are manually taming it right now. And it's up to 15% after like 30 seconds or a minute or something like that. So we might actually go, don't want to accidentally punch that thing. Ooh, we might actually get this thing tamed with probably like a 95% tame or a 95 level taming bonus, which is really good. I think I'm going to pause recording though. Looks like our Alpha Argy over there grew up and is a full-on adult right now, so I'm going to have to do a lot of off-camera work to try and get that thing nice and maxed out and whatnot. Try and get improve all of our critter's armor, like all the Alpha armor and whatnot, as well as the T-Rex armor and all that, as well as trying to level up all the T-Rexes and, you know, try and max them out and stuff so we can do the Manticore battle within, I'd say, the next episode or two. That's what I want to try and do. So I've got a lot of off-camera work ahead of me. Let me go check up on the female over here. How long until, the female, okay, 16 minutes until she can mate. Nice! That's some good stuff. Okay, it looks like the T-Rex or someone over here wants some care. You just want to go on a walk with me. Oh, level 214 T-Rex, not bad. Let's get her to be on a walk with me. Hopefully, okay, let's continue on with the taming of this. There we go, up to 38% right there, not bad. Let's see if we can just keep moving around like this. Get the T-Rex to keep following us. And, come on, get over here. Man, we can't really get that thing. Is that 54? I think I'm going to try and prioritize taming the Ankylo right now. I'm going to pause the recording, try and tame the Ankylo Then I'm going to try and level up the T-Rexes, try and improve all the armor and stuff all over the place, as well as my armor. My armor's not really that good. Maybe I'll try and make, like, riot armor or something here in the future. If you guys are watching my other ARC series, you know that we have something called an augmentation station. Ooh, look at that, the taming effect, and this went down to 96. It's not that good. But an augmentation station. So we could put on, like, riot armor and give it really good hyperthermic insulation. That way we could wear it out here in the super hot areas and not be super burning up all the time. So, I'm like, that's a big old poop. We haven't gotten a single piece of alpha armor, so riot armor is going to be our best bet for, you know, upgrading it and whatnot. So I think that's what I'm going to do off camera as well. But I'm going to do so much stuff off camera right now. So I'm going to pause the recording and I'll see you guys here in a bit. And let's see how much stuff I can get done. Hopefully I can get a really good amount of stuff done and we can do the Manticore battle next episode or two. So I'll see you guys here in a bit. Hey guys, back and check it out. So I'm over here. I built an augmentation station. You guys might have seen this in my other ARC series. I'm starting to, you know, improve the armor rating of the T-Rex saddles and stuff. I'm probably going to do that for the Alpha RG saddles too. But the egg hatched. The egg hatched. Or, I don't think I said this on camera, but they breeded. Oh! Speaking of breeding and another egg, I moved the other female over here, so we have another egg over here. There we go. But the other ones, the high-level female and the male, they had an egg, and then the egg hatched into triplets. Check it out. One level 187, two and three level 187. They all got to have the same level. I wonder if they have the same baseline stats. 17 for melee damage, 26 health. 17 melee. Oh, wait, hold on. 17 melee damage, 26. Okay, so these are going to be some high-hitting, a lot of health critters over here. But then again, it might change whenever they actually turn into adults. But, man, I was expecting one. We ended up getting three. So right now, including this egg, assuming this egg will give us just one alpha wyvern. Let me check, because I'm updating the groups over here. Boss Rexes, we have six T-Rexes right now. Alpha RGs, we have 12 alpha RGs right now. Plus the six T-Rexes, that's 18. Plus the one possible alpha archer we're going to get from this. So we're going to have 19 out of the 20 critters we could take to the Manticore battle. I think we want to wait for these guys, for the, wait, hold on, maturation. The female, look at this. The female T-Rex over here can mate in about 10 more minutes. So going to wait for them to have one more baby. And you guys, I guess what's going to happen is we're going to have 13 alpha RGs, seven T-Rexes. That should be a really, really good battle, especially when we start upgrading their armor and whatnot at the augmentation station. What are we doing all that stuff off camera? But I'm going to need to get on my mantis to get more stuff. But I might as well use the augmentation station to make the sickle like a celestial level or something crazy. So I'm going to do that. But if you guys watch my other ARC series, you guys already know how I do that, and it's going to be kind of boring and repetitive. So I'm going to pause the recording, continue, you know, preparing for the upcoming Manticore battle. Just wanted to record this bit to let you guys know we got some insane triplets. Oh, by the way, I'm probably going to need to get there's Palmer over here. Perfect, I'm going to need that. But raw anything. I'm going to need to give it to the babies so they actually have something to eat, you know, because they are fresh babies. They don't have anything in their inventory right now, so I'm going to put a little bit of food in their inventory just so they're good to go. And maybe even the T-Rex as well. I don't know if the baby or adolescent T-Rex, don't think she has anything in her inventory, so there we go. And this one should be the last one, and yep. There we go. All right, so they all have food right now. Noish. How long until this egg hatches? About 15 minutes. Okay, not bad. Not bad. Man, I am feeling good. I am really feeling like this Manticore battle is just around the corner, so definitely stay tuned. I'm going to pause the recording right now, and hopefully when I come back, I'm going to have all the armor for all the RGs and T-Rexes nice and improved, ready for them to, you know, just max out on level, max out on melee damage or health or whatever I'm going to do. So going to pause the recording real quick, and I will see you guys here in a bit. Hey guys, back, and check it out. We got a lot of really good progress done since I paused the recording. So I have full armor on right now that is upgraded as best as I can with all the materials that I have. I said I was going to make a full set of riot armor. I decided to do that. That's a riot helmet. Okay, so I have a riot helmet, riot chest plate, riot boots, and then I have, desert cloth gloves. That's what I have. I have celestial level desert cloth gloves, of course, with the wyvern glove skin, and desert cloth pants over here. And I think it's a really good combination of all those, because the riot gear does give me better armor rating when it's upgraded and stuff. And of course, the desert cloth is the best with hyperthermic insulation. And the reason why, oh my, You just had to take a big old dump right next to me, Mango. Jeez. But the reason why I picked the pants and the gloves to be desert cloth is because I have the best hyperthermic insulation. You can see hyperthermic insulation is 138.4 on the gloves and 163.6 on the pants. I did upgrade everything to Celestial, everything desert cloth to Celestial. And as you can see over here, Celestial desert goggles and hat, they're only hyperthermic insulation up to 103.3, 72.6 on the boots, and 80.9 on the shirt. So that's the reason why I got the pants and the gloves, because they have, you know, better hyperthermic insulation, and I can make everything else the epic level riot stuff. And I improved everything over here to the highest armor rating at the augmentation station, as well as the highest hyperthermic insulation. For some reason, the riot gear only got like one upgrade of hyperthermic insulation at the augmentation station, which is kind of fun to say. And as you see, I still have 17 armor reagents left over. And speaking of armor reagents, I should probably put the Manticore helmet skin back on. There you go. Speaking of armor reagents, I did apply some of that to every critter we're taking to the boss battle. All the alpha RGs, they have common alpha RG saddles, or uncommon alpha RG saddles. I think it was an armor rating of like 50 before, and now it's up to 250. It wasn't 250 after I made it uncommon. I had to use a bunch of armor reagents to kind of buff the armor rating all the way up to 250, which I guess is the limit for what you could do for uncommon alpha RG saddles. Over here, we have the same thing. So all the alpha RGs have the same uncommon alpha RG saddle with 250 armor rating, except for Ho-Oh. Ho-Oh, because I'm going to be, you know, I'm going to be riding on Ho-Oh during the boss battle. I decided to give Ho-Oh a rare level alpha saddle right there, which has an armor rating of 350, which, what was it, 250 over here compared to 350? It's definitely a lot more, especially because I'm going to be riding it. I'm a little bit more important, because if I die, everyone else dies, right? Yeah, 250 armor over here, 350 over there. I think it's fair. And like I said, every alpha RG has the uncommon 250 armor rating alpha saddle on them, including the ones over here. Oh, whoa, these are adults now. Okay, well, I put the saddle in their inventory, just, you know, waiting for them to grow up and whatnot. But this one needs caring about a minute and a half. But it already has 100% imprinting. I think that one, I think it's like lower level. Yeah, it's 144 compared to 187 of all those triplets. So I don't think we're going to be taking this one. That's why it doesn't have a saddle in its inventory. But all the triplets over here, they have saddles in their inventories. There you go. I guess I'll just do that. And of course, I'm going to need to, you know, level them all up here in a bit, which is going to take a little while, but of course I could just pause the recording and get that done off camera so you guys don't have to see me repeat the process over and over again. But we do have another Rex over here, Juvenile Tyrannosaurus Rex, level 246, right off the bat, really good level. Needs care in about 29 minutes, has 26% imprinting already, not bad. Let's go check out all the T-Rexes over here. It is nighttime, but over here, all the T-Rexes, they have, I guess I have a thing, yeah, we have a torch. They do have a lot of level ups, did a lot of level ups with them, you know, killed a bunch of death worms and whatnot. They do have, this one has an epic level saddle, which is 225 armor rating, which of course, like I said earlier, the armor reagent, I maxed that all out. This one is a legendary one with 275% armor rating, and the reason why is because some of them, you know, they skip, like, one thing whenever I'm improving them, like, they might go from like uncommon to epic or something like that, or rare all the way to legendary or something. So I can, even though I said I wanted them all to be like epic or rare level, some of them just skip past it, and I just kind of be like, okay, I guess I'll just give it to them anyways. you can see, yeah, this one is an epic level saddle. You can see, oh yeah, 1,000 melee damage. Some of them I'm prioritizing melee damage on all these guys, trying to get them all up to like 1,000-ish. This one's up to 500. I think this one, yeah, this one had like really good health or something, so I buffed its health up a lot. What's the health on this one? Yeah, 29 compared to 22 on the melee damage. So you can see this one has 54,000 health, only 500% melee damage so far, and kind of close to maxing out. Probably only has like a handful of levels till we're till that one's maxed out. But this one's got 1,000 armor rating and only 23,000 health. But of course, the saddle with that really good armor rating is definitely going to help out and protect it during the boss battle. Same thing with this one, probably a couple levels away. It's probably going to have like 20,000 health whenever it's maxed out. And you can see it has 1,018 melee damage. And they're not all maxed out. I don't have any more of those experience potions. And killing death worms with it is probably the best way of doing it, but you can't find them all the time. Of course, there is that trick where you can kind of like glitch through the bottom of the map and try and look at them. But that isn't always reliable because they have to be there in the first place, you know? Anyways, as you can see, a lot of them have about 1,000 melee damage. Probably going to do the same thing for the juvenile Rex over here. Oh, man, the door is still open. Okay, well, good thing no one escaped. Is this? Yeah, let's set to automatic. Why did it not close? What in the world? Auto-open and close. It should be auto-close right now. I don't know why it wasn't doing that. Anyways, so I guess all I'm going to do now is wait for the juvenile Tyrannosaurus Rex to level up, or to turn into an adult, and then level that up. Level up the triplet Argies over here, and then we'll be good to go. I think we'll be ready to take on the Manticore battle maybe next episode or something like that. I don't know, depending on how much progress I get done between this episode and next episode. I guess, if anything, yeah, I could make potions. That's what we did in the other... Well, we didn't make them in the other series. We just kind of... Wait, what's this? Oh, I thought that green thing was like a status symbol on my top right. It was kind of like this. I thought it was like a status symbol on the top right telling me something. But I guess we could make health potions. So, oh, and we also have health boosters. Potion. Is there no, health potions that I can make for this? Medium health potion? I guess not. Seems like it's a rare drop from, critters as well as a supply drop. So, I might as well use this time where I'm just kind of waiting around for them to grow up. Might as well just use this time to, fly around with, I guess, maybe Ho-Oh or someone. And see if we could, find some more health potions. But, yeah, the health booster is the only thing I could see inside here. Let me see if there's anything else that might be kind of beneficial to us during the boss battle, at least. I think we have the best armor for right now. Agility booster, I don't think I need that. An agility potion to recover your creature's lost stamina. Ooh, that could be... Huh! That would have been really helpful back in the day. A couple episodes ago, you guys remember whenever we were with our BARG, and he kept on running out of stamina when it was trying to knock out the Alpha RGs. That would have been really helpful. Hold on. Yeah, what else do we have here that might be really, really good? Let's see, the oxygen booster, when exploring at the depths. Yeah, we don't really need that very much. I'm trying to see if there's anything else that might be beneficial for the actual boss battle itself. Does that health booster thing, does that, because we unlocked it before, I think. Yeah, this health booster, does that work on me? A healing potion for mending your creature's wounds, restores 100% health, but comes with a cooldown. Doesn't work when under the effect of bleeding. Yeah, I should probably make a couple of those for Ho-Oh, just in case. Ho-Oh starts taking damage and whatnot. Need to make a couple of those. And of course I can make them no problem. It looks like you can make them with a sedative narcotic. And we can make those pretty easily because we do have a lot of rare mushrooms, rare flowers that we've been picking up lately. Over here we have 71 rare mushrooms and 90 rare flowers. Not bad. I think we need 20 rare flowers, 40 rare mushrooms. So we can almost make 2 sedative narcotics. And I think I was editing my footage for this episode, by the way, because I'm pausing the recording, doing a lot of work, and then pausing the recording again over and over again. This episode is crazy. I'm getting like a week's worth of like progress done in this one episode. It's awesome. Anyways, I didn't really tell you guys about the Ankylo over here. So let's go pick up this Ankylo. Let's go take this Ankylo upwards, up here. And I guess, kind of ran into the, Griffin right there. Need to watch out for that. But up here, this Ankylo, we got tamed. I don't know what it was baseline. It was like probably like just under level 300, like I said. But this Ankylo is really, really good. Let me get my torch out. It is kind of dark. There we go. Level 345 right now. Almost 20,000 XP. You know, getting level ups here and there. But she is really, really good at getting like rare mushrooms and rare flower. Not like the best, but she gets them like, I'd say, noticeably more often than Tank the Ankylo. And you can see Tank, she's already higher level than Tank the Ankylo. I think after the taming bonus, just like right after the taming bonus. So, you know, of course, oh yeah, let's see if her baseline stats went up any after the taming bonus. Oh my god, yeah. Melee damage is up to 51 and health is 37. Man, that is good. That's probably why I upgrade melee damage so much, up to 836 right there. Not bad. 836%. Man, that is good stuff. But I'm over here harvesting these purple flowers, trying to get like rare mushrooms, rare flowers, because it seems like these, yeah, there you go, 3 rare mushrooms right there. And of course it's not like the other map, like the center or anything, that has like a swamp. And of course swamps, they have rare mushrooms, rare flowers for days. You can see in the other arc series, we just got insane amounts of Opalthor. There is Enosaur, but in Scorched Earth, of course there's no swamps. There's barely even any water. So we kind of have to rely on these purple flowers over here, which I don't know if they actually, you know, give it better than other flowers, or if it's just kind of a coincidence. I was just like, you know what, I got a lot of rare flowers from these purple flowers. I guess I'm going to keep on getting them. I don't know, but it seems to be the case, because I'm always going to like purple little Oh, I guess I'm an Ankylo. I'm on an Ankylo, right? I might as well break these rocks if I can't move, right? But it always seems like we're getting way more flowers from the purple ones. So that's why I'm over here trying to get... Yeah, look at that one rare mushroom right there. Not bad. Not bad. And of course, they are rare mushrooms and rare flowers. So if you got like a billion of them at once, they wouldn't be really rare, would they? Anyways, I guess what I'm going to do now is just, you know, pause the recording. Wait for the T-Rex over there to grow up. I don't know. Maybe I'll just try and kill a bunch of random stuff with my RGs. Mantises and stuff. They always seem to, like, drop experience potions every now and then, but I'll try and get, like, experience potions to help out. Because, of course, getting the little explorer notes, you guys know those little things inside of chests that kind of give you a 10-minute double XP bonus? I can't really find too many more of those things. I guess I could cheat and go look it up and find out exactly where they are. I guess I could do that, but I guess I'm going to try and kill a bunch more mantises and stuff, too. Yeah, you can see that. I just got a rare flower right there. Try and kill some mantises. Maybe just some other critters. You know, go to some supply drops, too. I'm pretty sure supply drops also drop experience potions, too. I just need to be very mindful of where they are, what colors are which on the hierarchy. Hopefully the higher level ones will give us the experience potions like I want. Tell the Ankylo to follow us, and let's go pick him up and bring him. Actually, it is a female, isn't it? Yep, it is. Okay, yeah, so I can't mate this one with Tank the Ankylo, unfortunately, but not a big deal. Anyways, let's go back to Ho-Oh now. And we brought, how many rare mushrooms, how many rare flowers did we get right there while just kind of rambling on about whatever? 6 rare mushrooms, 6 rare flowers, not the worst! Honestly, not even the worst! Probably would have got only, probably like half that with Tank the Ankylo. I'm not over here bashing Tank, saying that Tank was trash, it's just that, you know, this one's a little bit better, and of course we always need an upgrade, and we've been using Tank for the longest time, so it's definitely good that we finally got ourselves a new Ankylo. And of course this one gets an insane amount of obsidian. I think I needed a lot of obsidian for the Alpha RG saddles to make them from common to uncommon, that little upgrade. So I am so glad that we got this Ankylo, because she gets insane amounts of not only metal, but obsidian and pretty much anything else that she harvests well, like even like flint. You can see even berries and stuff. Like, look at all these berries. Look at all these berries. Let me grab all these let me grab the seeds. Let me drop the seeds off, because I don't need those seeds. But can I carry this? I can't. Oh, jeez, yeah, I can't. 844 pounds of berries, man! Okay, well, let's go put these in the feeding troughs. I need to go replenish the feeding troughs. Anyways, so let's go over there and let's go fill up the feeding troughs again. Why are we, like, barely able to move? Oh, yeah, we have a lot of cactus sap on us, don't we? Yeah, there we go. Get oh, jeez. 3,000. I guess I could have used that to make a bunch more clay for adobe stuff, but eh. If we need more, we can just get more with our Ankylo. Yeah, you see the feeding troughs are completely empty over here. Yeah, let's get the narco berries. Let's keep the narco berries on her there, and the stim berries, because we need to make more stimulants and narcotics here. I still can't move. Okay, let's keep on giving her stuff. Okay, jeez. And oh wait, why is it? There we go. Get rid of those labels. Anyways, nah. Wait, can I move? I can barely. Okay, there we go. Sheesh. Now I can move. Let's fill this up with some berries. I need to fill it up with some meat here in a bit as well. Which shouldn't be too hard. We get a lot of meat from the T-Rexes, so I'll just. Oh. We're getting a lot of lag right now. We're back. Jeez. Anyways, I guess I'll just get Miho berries. Yeah, I'll just type in each one automatically. Azul berries for the blue ones. And oh, I can't move. Can't move. Might as well. There you go. Ooh, let's put those all up inside. That should be enough. I'm going to go fill up some other feeding troughs real quick. But anyways, I'm going to pause the recording, wait for the T-Rex to grow up, and then level that up. And then level up those triplet Alpha RGs. Try and level those up, and hopefully next episode we can take on the Manticore, because I'm pretty sure we have everything. And I don't know. Oh, yeah, look at that Terror Bird egg. I don't know which one. I think we should do what we did in the other arc series, where we save the game right before we start the boss battle. Do the easy boss battle. If it turns out to be really easy, we could reload the save from before the boss battle, do the medium boss battle instead. And then if that turns out to be too easy, we could reload the save again and then do the, oh man, another egg. And then do the hard boss battle. If that turns out to be super easy, then that's good for us, because that's the highest one we could do. And of course we're going to get a little bit of element, and we can get a lot of tech rems from killing the bosses. But I'd really like to start from the bottom, work our way up, and hopefully we'll be able to actually take on the hard boss battle instead of, you know, trying to go there immediately and brag and be like, yeah, I'm going to take on the hard boss battle right now. It's a big boatload of nothing.
Yep, I'm not bragging.
Anyways, I forgot to mention this. I think I said earlier in the episode I was going to tell you guys what I did with the Lyshosauruses, but... Oh, this one's unclaimed, okay. But I got rid of them all. I took them out, unclaimed them. You guys told me to unclaim them. Some of you guys told me to shoot them with, like, rockets or whatever, but I didn't want to do that because, of course, rockets, they do friendly fire damage, and, of course, I damage or even maybe kill some of my nearby critters, maybe even my snail, and even my buildings. So I didn't want to do that, but I picked each and every one of them up with one of my Alpha Archies and just unclaimed them and just moved them somewhere else around the map because we don't really need them. And if I kept them over here but, like, let them roam around in the area of Enem Boss, and by the way, I also neutered or spayed the female, I think. I think spay is for female, so I don't know how to check it. It says right there, gender female spayed. So I might as well neuter the male over here, casually, right in front of y'all, you guys. just to make sure that they don't start breeding like bunnies. There we go. So now they shouldn't be able to mate. Hey, let me pick up my snail. He's kind of stuck. She or whatever. Literally a level 519 snail. Or actually, it doesn't have a gender at all. Oh, look at that little bit of Akatina paste and organic polymer. Always nice to have. Anyways, that's what I did with the Lyshosauruses, if you guys were wondering. So, anyways, like I said a billion times, I'm going to pause the recording, and actually, I think I'm going to end the episode right here. It's getting a little bit long, so I think what we're going to do is really try and do a lot of work between this episode and next episode, and I promise, next episode, we're taking on the Manticore. We can do it. I think, I'm pretty sure we have all the towns over here, or Wyvern. Wyvern talents. We have all the fire, lightning, and poison talents we need. We have all three artifacts to activate the terminal to teleport to the boss arena. We could do it, you guys, so definitely look forward to that next episode. So thank you guys all very much for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to let me know by leaving a like down below. And if you guys want more of these awesome videos, be sure to hit that subscribe button. That'll put my latest videos on YouTube homepage as soon as they come out so you do not miss an episode. And if you guys have any tips for the Manticore battle, feel free to leave them down in the comments down below, because I think I'm about as prepared as I can get with all the health boosters I'm going to be crafting, the really good armor I have for not only myself, but all my critters we're going to be taking. And hopefully I can find some more of these health potions right here, just in case I myself take damage. I can take those health potions in the middle of the battle, heal myself up to full health, and hopefully we'll be good to go. But that's next episode when we take on the Manticore battle, so until then, thank you guys all for watching, and I will see you guys here next time. Oh, bye there.